Organization in for loops is usually very important. The program does most of it for you, but if you're not careful, you can easily lose things or misplace stuff. It accommodates for your own specific organizational needs and really helps you out with this sort of thing, and naming and setting key values for each beat. Let's see how that works. As you can see with this sliced beat, there is 24 slices in this beat, ranging between B4 and C7. Now, say I wanted slice number one to actually be down here at C4 because I'm used to it being there. Maybe that's how that works. If I go over here to this individual sample, this is the beat. You see it's highlighting up there. Here is the name, slice number one, and here's the note value. Click on the note value, and you can actually change it to any note that's on the piano roll, which actually has 120 note values that you can use. So I wanted to set it to C4. And then there it is, it's down there. Say I wanted to call it kick. It actually has a couple of suggested names that you can use, so I'll just use bass drum 1. And it didn't really fit, but that's what it's called now. It's called bass drum 1. This sort of thing works for when you want to do things like fix it to general MIDI drum patterns. Like in general MIDI, the kick is on C3 and the snare is on D3 and E3, and then the hat's on F sharp. So you can set that by doing that with the slicer.